give you some top tips about how to structure your home workout so that it's really effective and also really safe. Now, if you're doing a class with your regular teacher, they'll be structuring this for you, so you don't have to think too much about it. They'll also be pitching it at exactly the right level for you, so this is definitely our preferred option. However, the Australian Guidelines for Physical Activity recommend that we do at least 60 minutes of moderate to vigorous physical activity every day. It's unlikely that your teachers will be giving you classes every single day. So when you are structuring your own workout at home, there are a couple of things we want you to remember. In particular, warm up, body of the class, and cool down. Let's talk through those three things. Firstly, the warm up. So with your warm up, what you're aiming to do is to increase your heart rate, or if you like, to increase your rate of breathing so that you might find it, you're able to carry on a conversation, but you might find it difficult to sing. It's not about stretching. We don't want you to do long, prolonged stretches before a workout. It's about pumping the blood to your muscles so that your body literally warms up and you're preparing your muscles and your joints for what's to come. So it might be jogging on the spot. It might be high knees. It might be feet to your buttocks. It could be squats or star jumps or running up and down your staircase 5 times. Essentially, you want to continue on that level of exercise for 3 to 5 minutes before you start your class. For the body of your class, generally we want to start with the easier steps and build in complexity as you progress through the class. However, be really careful that you're not performing the complex or really risky parts of your class towards the end of the class if you're feeling physically fatigued. This is a classic time for injuries to occur. We recommend building towards the more complex parts of your class by mid-class and progressing beyond that with complexity only if you feel like your body's coping well with that. Remember, never push through pain. When you're dancing at home, it's not a good time to push through any discomfort. And finally, if you are finding that you're using an online class that you've found on YouTube, just make sure that it's pitched at the right level for you. If you're not sure, talk to your dance teacher. They might even have some suggestions of classes that you can use online that are more appropriate for your level. Finally, your cool down. This is a lovely time to stretch. When your muscles are warm, they'll respond really well to some prolonged stretches and you'll get the most out of these. So basically, we've talked so far about the structure of a normal dance class. I want to talk to you today as well about cross training. Basically, cross training is any form of alternative exercise that you're not used to. So for dancers, it might be swimming or running or jumping with a rope if you prefer. HIIT training, H-I-I-T, stands for High Intensity Interval Training. And that's a form of cross training that you can do in your home. Essentially, it's a period of high intensity exercise. So you might do 20 seconds of really high intensity exercise where you're increasing your heart rate right to near its maximum, followed by a period of recovery exercise where you catch your breath again, and then you repeat that same high intensity, low intensity for up to 20 minutes or so. I've put together a 15-minute HIIT workout for you today, so you can look at what an example of a HIIT workout may look like for you. So, start with your 3 to 5 minute warm-up, such as we've discussed. Then you want to come into 20 seconds of squats, but you're wanting to push yourself so your heart rate is really increasing. It might mean you need to pulse them down there, or even do some squat thrusts, if that is what you require to get your heart rate right up. After your 20 seconds, your recovery phase might be 10 seconds of jogging on the spot while you catch your breath. And then you come back into that 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Repeat that for 4 minutes. Now, your second set of 4 minutes, you might do burpees for 20 seconds on and a recovery jog for 10 seconds for your off time. Repeat that for 4 minutes. Your final set of 4 minutes might be 20 seconds of sit-ups, followed by 10 seconds of rolling your knees side to side. Make sure you remember to stretch to cool down. So, if you're structuring your own class at home, always remember, warm up, build through the intensity of your class, but not if you're feeling like you're fatigued, and HIIT training is a good option as a cross training, and finish with stretching to cool down. So that's it. Enjoy dancing while you're distance.